With us now is Dr. Manny. Welcome to the show. How are you?
Great, great. Having a wonderful time.
So I got to meet you at breakfast, but now it's kind of lunchtime. They've got like a grill. They're grilling burgers.
Absolutely. Everybody's getting the calories in.
What made you decide to participate in today's fundraiser?
Well, listen, this is about cystic fibrosis. As an OBGYN and somebody who deals with kids with cystic fibrosis all the time, a lot of research is still needed. You know, we can make the diagnosis of cystic fibrosis in pregnant women, but we still have a lot of mutations of cystic fibrosis that are unknown. This is a disease that can be beaten, and it will be beaten. With strong research and clinical support. I mean, these young adults and kids, with the proper therapy, we can really change the outlook for their lives. But again, research, medical research is supported not only by the federal government, but it's also supported by people who donate their time and effort and money to give scientists and all the support health systems the resources that they need to make these children better.
One of the things I wanted to ask you is that being an OBGYN, how is that diagnosed? How is CF diagnosed ahead of time before the baby's born? Is it through an ultrasound, an amniocentesis? How do you know?
Well, cystic fibrosis is a genetic disease that is recessive. So we typically screen all pregnant women for cystic fibrosis. And if they have one of the mutations, then we test their partners. When you have two mutations, then the child has probability of having the disease, and then we will do an amniocentesis to corroborate that.
Okay.
The problem is that there are many mutations of cystic fibrosis that are still changing, and this is the one of the things that scientists are tackling with. But we can make the diagnosis prenatally, and once we do, then a whole course of action can be taken, especially when the child is born.
It's not like you're looking at an ultrasound and then you're seeing like little spots on the baby's lungs.
No. A child with cystic fibrosis looks like any other child. They're born with the same characteristics as a healthy child. It's only until they get a little bit bigger that you start seeing the symptoms, and they're expressed with, you know, pulmonary difficulty and mucus and things of the sort. And of course, this affects their overall system. That's why it's very important. And you heard here before how important it is to keep good sanitary conditions, especially if you are dealing with children with cystic fibrosis. You don't want to give them a secondary infection like the flu.
Or even in the OR, right? Do you take extra steps? I'm sure it's like as sanitary as it possibly can be. But you're putting that baby maybe in a NICU right after it's born?
No, not necessarily. Okay. The diagnosis is made, again, the symptoms begin to evolve once that baby has a few extra months of life. And you see it as they thrive, as they get more encounter with the environment. But not. At the time of birth, these children look as healthy and beautiful as anybody else.
So there's a good chance then that once a cure could be found, or a medication or something like that, that they wouldn't be symptomatic.
And that's the whole thing. I mean, if we are able to regulate that genetic expression of cystic fibrosis, then absolutely it would be a chronic disease rather than, you know, something else.
Excellent. Let's go for that.
You got it. We have to do it.
We got to do it.
We got to do it.
Stay tuned.